CEO of a very unique and fast-growing business. It's called All You Can Arcade. What it is they bring a full-size arcade game to your home. It's your game. You can play it as much as you want. After a month, they swap it out with a different one. You know, we had a water cooler guy. Remember who used to just bring the water cooler and every month he'd come and fill the water cooler? It's a service like that.
Right, yeah. And you, if you love that game, you can skip a month or whatever. Right. When you get tired of it, they'll bring you a new one.
He charges $75 a month and includes delivery. Seth Peterson, where are you located?
We're in Antioch, California, right outside of the San Francisco Bay Area.
Oh, well, you're not doing it here in Seattle?
Not yet, but, you know, our business model, we're crowdsourcing our arcade deliveries, and so there are people listening to your radio show right now who have arcade games sitting in their garage catching dust and all kinds of other things. And just like you can put your home up on Airbnb or your car up on Lyft.com, you can now put your arcade games on allyoucanarcade.com, and we'll pay you money in order to rent that to your customers in Seattle.
Oh, wow. So let's say I have a game,
yeah,
and I'm willing to schlep it around once a month.
Sure.
How much of that $75 do I get?
Well, we pay out 75% of what we can ultimately earn from the customer. So if it's just a one game at a time, it's only going to be $56.25. But if somebody selects our three game at a package, we'll pay you $165 a month to put those three games into
contracts. What a great business model. So you're taking all these games that are sitting around there, just the way Uber is taking cars that are driving around for nothing, and you're saying, hey, make some money off of this stuff that's sitting in your garage.
Yeah, for the last, 5-10 years, these arcade games, when you put them on location, people just don't put quarters anymore. They've got their smartphones and their apps and their video games on their little cell phones, and so they haven't been feeding these machines, and so they've stopped earning. And we've got arcade operators all over the United States who are trying to struggle through this, and they're wondering, how the heck am I going to make a living? And meanwhile, all these games are sitting there idle, and we just think people just want to play them. They love to play them. They miss Frogger and Tempest and Star Wars and all these other games.
Right. And so you get a commission. Does this apply to pinball machines, too?
I wish. We own allyoucanpinball.com, and we hope to offer pinballs one day. But, pinballs these days go anywhere from $2,000 to $4,000 a piece.
So right. And they're high maintenance, too, because they have moving parts.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Tiny, tiny little things that break, and then you can never replace them. So there's some problems that we got to work through on the pinball.
Yeah, like where to put them in a landfill. Hang on to the domain name, but you're probably never going to. I mean, this other one, these computerized arcade games, that's a cool legacy business. It's sort of like some people want to bring back vinyl albums.
Oh, yeah.
Guys, like especially guys my age, would love to have Asteroids in their garage so when they have a party or a picnic or something, everybody has fun.
Well, and the dirty little secret is once we put that Asteroids into your garage, in about 3 weeks of, you're going to get tired of that game. And so, some people will go out and they'll buy that Asteroids game for $800 and they'll play it and then they kind of kick themselves because it's just sitting there, and that's when they do start gathering dust. But we think if you can change your game every single month,
right,
that's just awesome.
Yeah. And so so people do buy and sell these. I actually owned a couple. I owned Ms. Pac-Man and Asteroids for a while. And you're right. After, like, I played them and I was like, aren't I cool? I have my 20s bar experience in my own garage. And my wife, by the way, did not think it was cool. Are you running into a lot of wife blowback from this?
Oh, my God. You should hear some of the stories. In fact, I would say probably over half of the games that we've sniped off of Craigslist for dirt cheap, they're coming from widows and ex-girlfriends.
Get rid of this thing.
Now, they get so worked up, blah, 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 and he cheated on me, and oh, my God, she looks like a horse, and, all this stuff. And, our job is just to say, man.
Our job is to take the game for dirt cheap. What do you give those gals, like $5 for the game?
We'll go in and we'll just listen to them complain about their boyfriend, about how bad he treated her, and then we'll offer them $25 a game and they'll sell it to us.
Yeah, bingo.
You're the man.
It was the listening that was priceless.
Yeah. Well, listening is what he's getting paid for.
I'm not sure, but, we feel bad for the guys because, if that happened to our games, boy, we would be flipped out.
Sure.
But, if we didn't buy them, somebody else would because, You know, they show up and they're gone within 5 minutes.
Do you also get a Corvette once in a while?
I wish. Yeah, we haven't seen that yet. But one of these days we're going to stick around for the bonfire to see it all light up, and that could be fun.
You mentioned the pumping quarters into them. Nobody wants to do that anymore. I certainly don't want to do that at my house. Do these things come disabled as far as having to feed them money to work?
Yeah, we put all of them on free play, and you know, we think a lot of games are more fun that way. There's some games that you could never beat in the arcades that cost you $500 to actually get to the end of the game, but you can actually finish the games at your home. You know, and I think also when people come over, they don't want to have to keep paying money and stuff, and so you can have almost a regular Friday night where you just be vegging out in front of the TV. It turns into this party atmosphere because people can play it and they can, you know, hang out with you. And it's just, it's a very, very unique experience. And
do you get any of these 21st century games, the golf game, the big buck hunter, the ones that are popular in bars these days?
A little bit. You know, the golden tees we see show up a lot. There's a lot of those that...
By the way, as soon as those women start divorcing their men, right, he'll have more of those games.
Those relationships are on the rocks, so stay close. Yeah.
This is fascinating. All right, so your business model, it's cool. I love this internet taking advantage of sharing things, networking so people can do stuff better. And that's what I see what you're doing. It's very bright. So your target person listening to us now is somebody who owns like a little truck that he could deliver these things in a hand truck and buys up a bunch of these games and starts, you know, networking through your site to deliver them online, right?
Yeah, you can buy these games for anywhere from $50 to $150. In fact, there was an auction just in your neighborhood this last weekend where a ton of games went for under $200. Huh. And if you can buy a game for $150 and you can put it on our website and you're getting even $50 a month after you pay gas because you're just driving to your neighbor's house,
sure,
to drop it off, you can get better returns on a Ms. Pac-Man game than the best hedge fund on Wall Street. And you don't even have to insider trade.
He's got his wrap down. You think you're going to get rich doing this, don't you?
I don't know. You know, there's a lot of liability because we're working with third parties. There's investors who just hate that business model. But then you do look at companies like Airbnb who've been successful. And right, I think that if we can make the games earn money again, there are millions of these games out there. And we think people want to earn $20 to $40 working as arcade repairmen. We think that we can pay them ultimately that much to do this.
Well, and it's a neat idea, and it's fascinating, and Seth, we're happy to give you a quick plug. Seth Peterson, Antioch, California. Go to our website, 957kjr.com, and search arcade after the show if you want to find out more. Thanks, Seth.
Hey, thank you for having me on.
All right.